Welcome everyone to Michigan International Speedway for our coverage of the Michigan 400. What can we expect in this race, Barney?
Well, look for speeds approaching 200 miles an hour and cars running 3 and 4 wide. That's a recipe for some exciting stuff.
Dale Earnhardt Jr. will begin the race in the top 5 in points.
Being in the top 5 is a huge boost in self-confidence. I know everyone on that team is very happy with their performance this season, and rightfully so.
Terry Labonte has strung together back-to-back top fives, and I'm sure he'll try for another one.
And let me tell you something, Joe. You throw in a couple of wins to go along with those top fives, and all of a sudden you're in the hunt for the championship.
Something a little out of the ordinary in this one for Ward Burton.
You're right. It's going to be tough for him. You get so used to starting up front, and then you have an off week, and you have to start towards the back. Then when race day comes, you feel like you passed 1,000 cars at the end. And worse yet, sometimes you never make it to the front.
Ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to NASCAR Thunder 2004 Let's Play. We're here in Michigan after a rough two races for Terry Labonte, a bad finish at Indianapolis, and a DNF at Watkins Glen. Looking to get back to going. Ryan Newman, Dale Earnhardt Jr. on the front row.
In the second row are Road 2,
Tony Stewart, and Dale Jr.
Starting the race from
row three
are the
Sterling Marlin
Dodge and the
Kurt Busch
Ford. The fourth row,
row four,
the Chevrolet
Jeff
and
Gordon
the Tide
and
Pontiac.
Ricky Craven. Starting the
Terry
fifth
Labonte,
row,
the NASCAR
championship leader by
later,
with a 383-point lead coming in today, and Michael Waltrip. All right, guys, here we go for the Michigan 400, 20 laps here in Michigan. Green flag is in the air, and here we go. Once again.
The 15 car, the pass. 3 wide, hold that line. All clear, buddy. Flat side. Number 2 is still there. Oh yeah, great pass, buddy. Clear all around.
Lap 1 is going to be in the books. Dropped a few spots on the restart. It's alright. Okay, somebody got in trouble on the back straightaway. A lot of cars got in trouble, but on the back straightaway. Okay, like half the field got broken up.
Slot pass. 3 wide. Okay, we're clear. Slot pass.
Sorry, Kurt.
Number 97 is gate.
Oh, Ricky!
Take it easy on those tires.
Wait, stay right there, Labonte.
97 car is still there. Make it easy. Clear on both sides.
Great save by us there.
About 1.5 off the lead.
It's all right. Long way to go here in Michigan. All of a sudden, just got out turn two, got in Craven, and just hit his sliding. Oh, the car got loose there.
Okay, clear.
I didn't want that. Looks like Tony Stewart's the race leader. Really, we got Rory or Kurt Busch doing that? Last two races for, well, three races, really, have been really tough on us. I'm Pocono, we recovered for a third place finish, but Brickyard, we struggled. We found a lot of trouble there. And then at Watkins Glen, try to play the fuel strategy game. We got too close to the fencing, to the metal fencing, spun ourselves. We got front end damage to the car. Ended up eventually giving us a DNF. Boy, there's Ryan Newman.
Number 12 is outside.
What happened to Stewart? Oh, yeah, what happened to Stewart?
Okay, we're clear. All right. The leaders are bitten. Still beside you. You've got the lead.
You just picked up 5 points for leading that lap.
Clear. Arlo. All clear, buddy.
Your right rear tire's wearing down.
Inside. Okay, we're clear.
Your left front tire's a little worn. There's some leaders coming in. That was a halfway mark. Gas tank is getting empty. Might be time for a new left rear tire.
Laps to go here in Michigan for Terry Labonte. It's been a wild day for Terry. Well, on the track battles.
Thank you.
out of gas. Looks like some of the leaders are headed down pit road.
Leaders are down pit road. Terry Labonte stays out on the racetrack. We are running out of the gas, coming to six to go. Just on speed.
Several cars now pull off the racetrack and begin the long journey down pit road. All the crews are all ready to make service to their cars. This is the race within the race to see who will get off pit road first. Jumps over the wall and begins to service this machine. This is their opportunity to shine. They can't make any mistakes here. It'll be a routine four-time change. They'll also put in two cans of gas. Four times of gas on this dock.
If that's the way to pick up time, you're on pit road. No mistakes in a good stop.
You got some traffic. Easy on the merge. You're clear.
Jimmy Johnson, gonna go by. Jarrett, gonna get around. Here comes Michael Waltrip.
Got one outside.
Five to go here in Michigan.
Clear all around.
You what, 3 seconds out?
Now 1.5.
Wow, 1.5 seconds.
5 more laps.
Climb high. Up to third, buddy. All clear, buddy.
Jarrett trying to block the bottom, not gonna happen. Going to turn one and two, Terry's gonna get second. Four of her tires on the five.
Okay, we're clear. Got one eye. Still beside you.
Jarrett gonna take second from Jim Johnson. Three to go here in Michigan. Here we go.
Now let's finish strong.
We're playing some of the stops by Dale Jarrett, Ryan Newman, Michael Waltrip, Jimmy Johnson in the top five. Last lap. I turned the car so good, got in the grass. Jared's not having enough of a run, he was too far back. Ryan Newman's gonna finish second for like the 20th time this season. All turn four, Terry Labonte will win a series record 14 races in a season. Terry Labonte wins in dominating fashion to Michigan. What a race.
Lead changes were pretty scarce.
Well, to be honest, Joe, I'm a little surprised that we didn't have more leaders. Just goes to show that with the right setup and the right strategy, you really can dominate a NASCAR Winston Cup race.
Terry Labonte ran in clean air pretty much all race long.
Now, this was a race he'll always remember. What a great feeling it must be to win a race in such a dominant fashion.
Final pass for the lead. Oh no, that's where we got the Tony Stewart. Great day already slowing. And we're celebrating victory lane in Michigan. Checkered flag in the air. Terry Labonte wins in Michigan. Interesting top 10. Ryan Newman with another top two finish. Dale Jarrett, Michael Waltrip, Kurt Busch, Jimmy Johnson, Jeff Gordon, Tony Stewart, Matt Kenseth, and Jeff Burton rounds out your top 10 today. A great day indeed. Up next will be the Sharpie 500 in Bristol, the Bristol night race. So thank you guys so much for watching. As always, drop a like, subscribe if you guys are new to the channel. I will leave you guys with a look at the championship standings as Terry Labonte has a 438 point lead over Dale Earnhardt Jr. with over 13 races to go on the season. Thank you guys for watching. Love you guys. I'll see you guys at Bristol. Later.